rule one that Grant told me is we can't practice our bad habit or bad fault. We have to find a way to practice the other side of things. If nothing else, to get your brain understanding that and make contact with the ball. So when Grant and I would start on this, we would have a contest with one another of what's the most, say we can get the shaft to lower, the most we can get the left wrist working this way, and then just make contact with a ball. It would say, okay, now let's try to do it even more. And really not worrying about where these balls are going, we're worried more about changing the picture. Watching a ball fly in the direction it's going is a really big inhibitor to changing a ball speed. Right, we have to change the picture first.
I call this neurological motion training, because we're trying to change a neurological pattern. You wake up every morning, your brain's very sophisticated, you walk the same way because it's the amygdala memory and it's encoded in there, right? Same thing with his golf swing, he's got that in there. Now, if he's got significant problems that he believes are significant problems, he has to change that. How do you change that? He has to be super aware of what he's doing. So I'll slow things down, make him do it more, speed it back up, try all kinds of things to kind of get him to develop some feels that's going to hold this mechanics together. So we actually do what I call like a golf yoga. So it's just very stressful in the neurological system. He's going to go slow, and he's going to really be mindful of what he's doing here. Very mindful, and then he releases it there and go. He's not going to swing like that when he's on the core. So this trains him on a neurological level, and now he has to start going to, okay, I'm going to actually make a swing. So he speeds it up a little faster, and then full speed, and then come back and do it again. But it ultimately, it has to translate into something he can use, so it has to be done as fast as possible as well.
Let's say we've made a couple of those really, really slow swings, and let's make it as fast as we can make it. Film that, we go back and do it again, and always associate, as Grant said, a picture to a feel. Everybody knows that feel and real is not the same.
We're using a camera, using your iPhone, can we just, it's such a great feedback tool.
I would always ask him, what do you think of that? Was that close to what we wanted to do? Is it far away? Is it exactly right? Is it too much? Right? And then he'd have to tell me, and then we can relate what he's feeling to the actual 2D image that we're looking at on that film. And if it's not, he's like, wow, I really felt it was a lot, but it really didn't move.
Sure.
So we need to feel the same thing more, right? Or try different strategies.
Because what we've learned, as I know you have, is whatever you do here on the range is going to regress a bit on the golf course.
Yes.
And then you go play two or three tournaments in a row, it's going to regress even more. So practice time, even the tournaments, has to be really disciplined and on the other side of whatever our concept may or may not be.
Sure.
So we'll talk through the slow one on what I'm trying to do here. I've got a big awareness here of width from P1 to 3 here. I'm continuing this back with my turn, so letting everything get powered around that way. An awareness of shoulder inclination with the center of mass of the shaft back, and then throw the hips under.
P1 to P3 for everybody wondering at home what that might be. It's just a way to describe different positions throughout the swing.
So then, my goal would be to take whatever feels I can from that and hit it as fast as I can. And we'll film both.
Yeah.
We'll film, say, the other side of it, what I'm really doing. We get disappointed, we do it again.
Yeah.